Hey, this is Cyberlink FX. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a muzzle flash on Windows Movie Maker. This will probably work with any version except for live, so let's get started. First, you need a video of yourself shooting a gun, although I've already imported that, so bring that down into the video track. Then you're going to find the exact shot, the exact frame where you pulled the trigger. So you can just play that until... Okay, about right there when I just pull the trigger and begin my kickback. So once you get there, go into Tools and take a picture from Preview. Save it to wherever you want. We save it on the desktop. I'm gonna call it. Gun Pick. Nice. And once you've saved that, you can minimize this and open up GIMP. Now GIMP is a really helpful program for picture editing, and it's also free. So you should probably go and download that. It's on the GIMP website. It's, as I mentioned before, it is free, so you might as well. So once this opens up, go get your picture. Okay. So now you have a picture of yourself shooting a gun. So what you're going to need now is a picture of a muzzle flash. You can get these from lots of websites. I just get mine from Google Images. And I'm going to open that as layers, so click that button. Okay, so I'm going to be using this one, so click open. And that's going to open up your muzzle flash. Now you can go select your muzzle flash using this move tool and go place it at the end of the gun. And if it's too big or too small, you can resize it. I like my muzzle flash is kind of big, so I'm going to keep it like that. And if you want it to follow the exact angle of the gun, you can tilt it by using the rotate tool. These are all very basic GIMP tools, very handy. Okay, then I'm just going to replace that at the end of the gun. Then once you've done that, select your muzzle flash, go into layer, mask, add layer, mask, and apply layer mask. And now you'll be able to select this fuzzy select tool. Select all of the black or whatever color is around your muzzle flash and just press delete. So, zoom in just so you can see what happened there. So as you can see, all the black is gone. There's still a little bit around the edges, so you can just select a little more of that. Get rid of all this black. Okay, that's better. And once you're done with that, by the way, the tool I used for that was the fuzzy select tool. If you missed that, when you're done, just go into select none, so there's nothing selected. If there's any, see these little bits of color around the edges, if there's any of that, just select your eraser and get rid of those. Okay, now that that's done, zoom back out, and we're pretty much done now. What I'm just going to do is I'm going to file and I'm going to save it as, I guess, just gun pick final. Save that to desktop. You just save it as a JPEG. Put up the quality. And now we're done with GIMP, so you can just X out of that. Now go back to Windows Movie Maker, find your picture. Here it is. Now, right here at the point where you actually took the picture, you right at that point, just press the split button, and that'll split it. Then take your gun pick and just place it right in there. This is obviously going to be way too long. Just scale it down as much as you can to make it really short, but it'll probably need to be shorter. So go into effects. You can add speed up half, sorry. Speed up double. Let's zoom in a little more so I can see what's going on. And you're going to want to make this thing really short, like really short. It's at the end, it should only be about one frame long. So if you go here, you can skip by frames. Then you come to this, and it's only one frame long. And that's pretty much all it is. On this same picture, you can find an effect that would add brightness. That makes it look a lot more realistic, as it makes it look like the flash is lighting up the room. Let's find brightness increase. You can add one of those. Let's see. Okay, maybe another one. So it's nice and bright. Okay, one more. There we go. Now all you have to do is go find yourself a gun sound effect. You can get these all over the internet. I like Sound Bible. That's where I get most of mine. Let's find a good one here. Okay, this is one of my favorites. Drag that below so it lines up with the muzzle flash. And whoa, wait a second, what just happened? Okay. And you're done. That's it. It's really cool that you could do muzzle flashes on a free program like Windows Movie Maker. And that's really all. This is CyberLink FX. See you next time.